tomorrow and next week and the week after. I will do this. And tomorrow, inshallah, 7 o'clock in the morning, I'll be doing such and such. 8 o'clock in the morning, I'll be 9 o'clock, I'll be such and such. I'm making this much money. This, I'm going to do this and so on and so forth. Okay, be my guest. Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether you can make it or not making it. Not making it, but I go to Allah. I go to Allah like what? Shaheed. In the highest level ever, when I leave this dunya, not to die in a regular way. No. Shaheed. And shaheed, not only for Jannah to be my place as eternal life. No. Take my parents with me too, because I'm shaheed. Take my spouse too, because I'm shaheed. Take my brothers and sisters with me, because I'm shaheed. This is the rank of shaheed. So when you wish to die as a shaheed, you have a special ranking, a special position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not like any other position millions and millions of Muslims would have. No, I want to be special to you, Allah. I want to be special to you, Allah, even when I leave. Wish for this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make you feel really, really, really good. وَرْقُدْ كَأَنَّكَ شَهِيدٌ. This is my end of my life. I want it to be done this way. Not to die like anyone would die, subhanallah, rabbil alameen. And then, subhanallah, Imam al-Shafi'i came to speaking part of the relationship with people around us, but as a good reminder, saying that وَلَا تَتَكَلَّمْ بِكَلَامٍ تَعْتَذِرُ بِهِ. Now it is the relationship, and I talk, I speak, I communicate with you. How about if I say something, I think, oh my God, I say something wrong to my brother, to my sister, to my fellows, to people around you. I'm sorry, you know, I do not mean it, wallahi, please forgive me. Why in the first place you put yourself to speak something and then later you realize that you're saying something wrong and I have to apologize? Why you put yourself in that very, very low situation? How you feel about it? Don't put yourself in that situation. Think about what you're going to say before you say it. Not to apologize. Make you feel good about yourself in your relationship with people around you. Last week we said, وَلَا تَنْسَ أَنَّ حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ تُطْفِئُ الْحَرِيقُ وَيَنْجُو بِهَا الْغَرِيقُ وَيُعْرَفُ بِهَا الطَّرِيقُ. You live in your life, again the relationship with people around you. But you feel that, wallahi, that person has oppressed me. ظَلَمَانِي. Those people were totally against me, and they do not have the right to be against me. Or some members of my family have done something and they are zalimeen, oppressing and suppressing me. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. The first impression, the first reaction of people as a human being, they did this. All right, I'll show them. I'm able and capable of having revenge. They talk to me this way, I'll show them how I'm going to talk. Swear at me once. 10 times, swear, you know, at me this way. I have the worst swearing ever. I can say it. La wallahi. Don't seek revenge. Hasbi Allah wa ni'am al-wakil. That's it. Part of the ayah of the Quran. Allah is my sufficient. He's the best to protect me and on behalf of me. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Anything happened to you, anything is said to you, any oppression, any suppression from anyone, from any deity, from any, subhanallah, power, hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. It would calm you down and you would feel good. If someone is oppressing you today in your salah or after you're done, say hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel and see how you feel. See how you feel. Subhanallah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. The last one, now relationship with myself, with my parents, with my friends, schoolmates, co-workers, the whole universe, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What was what is the last one in relationship to me it should be in order to live my happiest life? You forget Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You forget Rasulullah, Rasuluka, wa Nabiyuka, wa Habibuka, wa Shafi'uka yawm al-qiyamah. Don't forget him in your life. Don't forget him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. صلي وسلم على خير الخلق كلهم أجمعين تنال بها الرضا ويضاء لك بها ما ترى. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله. As many times as you can. As many times as you can. The happiest level ever you can get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once you say sallallahu alayka wa sallam ya رسول الله. Because he will make a special dua for you. On behalf of you. One thing. طيب. We live life, sometimes it is dark. It is not visible. We do not know where to go. The darkness of life, you see, عليك الصلاة والسلام يا رسول الله, it would enlighten your way of life. نور في الأرض. من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Try and see how happy you will be. Last week I talked about the life of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, how he was raised. His mom pregnant in him in 6 months, his father what happened? Died. While he was 6 years old, what happened to his mom? Died. Who took care of him? His grandpa Abu Talib died. Abu Talib died. Who took care of him? His uncle. Okay? يعني anyone should take care of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم did. طيب, I get married to Khadija رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. After a while, she's dead. The same year, his uncle Abu Talib dead. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling him, Muhammad, no one of the human being around you, we're the only one who's taking care of you. Period. Think of yourself. Have you ever had the same situation in terms of being yatim or losing your parents or your grandpa or your uncle or your wife in your life within a specific period of time? Answer me yes or no. None of you. Did Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم complain? لا والله. As a human being, feel, subhanAllah, يعني sad. Even with his son, Ibrahim, the only son he had, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to take Ibrahim. You, Ibrahim, also die. Till the point, he صلى الله عليه وسلم, إِنَّ الْعَيْنَ لَتَدْمَعُ وَإِنَّ الْقَلْبَ لَيَحْزَنُ وَإِنَّ عَلَى فِرَاقِكَ لَمَحْزُونُونَ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَلَكِنْ مَا نَقُولُ إِلَّا مَا يُرْضِي الرَّبِّ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. He as a human being, he said, I can cry. I can have that feeling of being sad because I lost my only son, subhanAllah. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll go back certainly, definitely, without any doubt. We belong to him, I'll go back to him. Have you ever had a situation like this in your life? If you do, compare yourself with Rasulullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wasn't, يعني subhanAllah, complaining. No. Continue his life, continue his da'wah, continue, you know, spreading the Quran and so on and so forth to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and live his life the happiest. Because he knew he has a job he has to perform. Do like him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Having all of the 13 points of your tongue, your feeling, your vision, your thinking, your relationship with people around you, and so on and so forth, it changed it to the best way according to Imam Shafi'i radiallahu anhu arda. You will live the best life, happily life, no sadness, no grief, nothing, even with that COVID-19 around you. Doesn't matter. We can live our life, we can survive. Live happily life. Don't show any sadness or lie to yourself, people around you, in your relationship. Inshallah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعلي بفضلك راية الحق الدين وانصرنا على عدوك وعدونا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر من نصر أمة محمد واجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل أمة محمد ولا تجعلنا منهم. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم آمنا في روعتنا. اللهم كن لنا ولا تكن علينا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك لا يرحمنا. اللهم برحمتك عمنا واكفنا شر ما أهمنا وعلى الإيمان الكامل والكتاب والسنة توفنا وأنت راض عنا. اغفر اللهم لنا ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولأخواتنا ولإخواننا في الله تعالى أحياء وأموات ولكل المسلمين أجمعين. إليه هذا حلنا لا يخفى عليك وهذا ضعفنا ظاهر بين يديك فعاملنا بالإحسان إذ الفضل منك وإليك واختم لنا بخاتمة السعادة أجمعين. عباد الله إن الله يأمركم بثلاث وأنهاكم عن ثلاث. إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وأنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم اشكروه يزيدكم قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمني ويرحمكم الله وأستودعكم الله.